This is my horsey that I've owned 2 months today.
Oh!
So I'm still...
Yes?
He would prefer that I have a better position because he's very sensitive.
Okay.
And I know my position. I mean, he's got all the buttons. He knows what to do.
Mm-hmm.
But he is probably used to having been muscled into it in the past. Because he's a pony, you know, he's a pony. He just, that's like, he'll do what he
fine.
Needs to do. But I am still very handsy and not, I don't think I always have the right position. I'm not using my leg correctly. I just want you to see what you see.
Okay.
And fix what you can.
Okay.
In a short time.
Okay.
I'm going to get this guy up. And
let's get that up that you can hear me well and everything. Good.
Right, Ranger? He says, can you make my mother not be so fussy? I just think this has got to go.
Okay.
Right.
All organized?
Yes.
Okay, so you've been walking around a little bit, I saw already, so...
And we warmed up outside. We did
warmed up a little,
canter,
okay.
Yes.
So just give him a little bit trot and canter very quick that I can have a little bit of a picture.
Okay.
And then I'll see where I can start helping you the most.
Okay, great.
Good.
Do you want someone coffee? Do you want water?
I think water now.
Water, okay.
Yeah. Just fine. Wow, I like this arena.
You like the arena?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
And it doesn't normally blow nowadays. But when it blows, it does.
Wow. Okay. What a nice match these two. Yes?
They just took the old horse up, but he's pretty much the spitting image of it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's really nice. Just give him a short canter on each rein. No, don't worry. Okay, and trot again, the same on the other rein. Okay, and then trot again. Okay, and just a short sitting trot once more. Yes, okay. Okay, and let him walk. Okay, so, it doesn't look like you know each other just such a short time, and it looks like a really good match. And, yes. Huh?
Yeah.
And of course, there are certain things in the transitions where sometimes it's a little bit too early, too late, the timing not yet perfectly together. But that's no big deal, because the general picture of harmony is there. That's really nice, you know? I can see quite a nice relaxed leg position, everything, and I can see you wearing that shirt because you're aware of you would like to sit a little bit and get this uprightness, but it's a difficulty. How do I build it up without getting stiff? And I prefer you'd rather be a little bit sloppy than that you get stiff. Yeah? Clear, I mean, the sitting trot is not quite there yet, and you can feel how you disturb him, and when you feel you disturb him, then you go completely, oh, I don't want this, you know? So that's something we will touch, but I want to give you some tools how to not disturb him in it, yeah? So that you can work on it without that you feel, oh, I shouldn't do that to him.
Right.
Yeah? Okay, let's stop for a second. I just want to check one thing.
She pooped all through that middle circle.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine.
I don't
fine.
Know if anyone
yeah.
wants to.
You
should get it.
Yeah, no, it's fine. Because there's a slight tendency of the saddle to go to the left.
Okay.
And just, that's, well, we'll have to just check it if it gets, if you have the feeling that gets worse, you may have to have a little bit adjustment saddle fitter coming once to just make sure. Because, okay, now he's standing a little bit like that, but then it doesn't help your balance.
Right,
and
right.
If that continues too much.
Like sometimes,
yeah, yeah.
I feel like
put a
more
bit
goes
more
over
weight.
To the right, because
yeah.
I feel like I get over
yeah.
here and
yeah.
I no longer
yeah.
stir up on that side.
And it just looks like the padding here of the saddle on that side is a little more than on this side.
Okay.
So it's something we won't
back. So we probably need some adjustment.
It yeah. may need a little bit adjusting. It's not impossible right now. We'll work with what we have. I just, because I noticed it, I said I'll point it out.
Okay.
It's not an impossibility. It just needs, and it's often when a horse comes to a new place, there's new things, then they change a little in the back.
Right, right.
Yeah, and after you get things, then sometimes after 6 weeks, you need to recheck them again.
Right.
So okay. that I just want to put that in your awareness and we'll go on with other things. Okay. To get you a little bit more secure and how to build up the tension here, start walking him. And think in your upper body, you're sitting really comfortable. You can make yourself short. And your head keeps looking straight, but you want to get 5 centimeters shorter. Yes. And then you start growing in your upper body a little bit. And then you get as tall as you can. And then you get into the middle again. And then you get short again. So that we have like middle, long, middle, short. Yeah? From collapse to stretch. Middle, long, middle, short. Middle, long. And then you get relatively quick through it. Middle, long, middle, short. Long, middle, okay, yes. And when you now do it quicker, it becomes more obvious that every time you relax yourself, you get behind the movement. Feel this? Now, see if you can do this relaxation like there's a gravity line going through your body that the head stays over the pelvis, because the horse moves forward. If you don't think a little bit forward, you get left behind. Because the horse, again, it travels your pelvis forward, but it doesn't travel your head and shoulders forward. So in that growing and lowering of your body, you need to keep, yes, you keep thinking forward. That is the difficulty of doing gymnastic on a forward-moving horse, in the difference of doing it in his Pilates studio or somewhere else where things don't move forward, you know? Because the horse moves your pelvis, you have to stay over that all the time. So we have to think a lot more forward. Yes. That's nice. Okay. Very good. Very good. Okay. Good. Okay, shorten the reins and ask for trot and rising trot. Oh, great. Thank you, Nina. Okay. Okay. Good. And as you have this nice big hat with a nice long shade on it, have a... No, no, I like that. Now, look through it and have the feeling that the line of your hat, the shade, and the horizon make one line. And even though you're going up and down, yeah, you look, you want to keep the horizon line even. Feel this? Yeah, so that it's not nodding the up and down, that you keep it very steady on the same line. The peak of your helmet and the horizon makes a horizon line that stays steady. And that means when you sit down, you actually have to stretch your back a little bit. Yes, because otherwise it has to go up and down, yeah? Yes, you get more elasticity in your back. That the rising trot is a warm-up for your back. Stretch it, stretch it, stretch it. Good, feel this? Okay, let's change the rein. I sometimes use pinhole glasses, but Felicitas took them off me and I have to get new ones. Where you can really, then the pinholes move if you don't keep the horizon equal. Very different reactions to riding with pinhole glasses from really, really completely. I mean, I rode with them in competition the whole warm up. I took them off going in. And it helped me keep my upper body forward and made me aware of when I stayed behind, especially in the mediums. So it's quite an interesting thing. But this concept of having a horizon line, having the head up there, it gives you a stability. Nothing, we can't stretch things if we fasten them on only one end, you know? You have to fasten them on two ends. If we want to stretch our back, if we don't give a virtual stability from the head, nothing in the middle will stretch. It'll just get instable. Yes.
You have to spot.
Spinning. Of course. Yeah. So the stability of the head position, not stiff but stable, yeah, is extremely important. You're doing a great job here. We're talking here, but I keep watching and I really like what you're doing. Okay, let him walk for a moment. How does that feel for you as a picture? Sorry.
Yeah. I think
I've never
really paid attention to
what's happening there. And plus, by looking there, you're not looking down on the horse.
Right, okay.
Yeah, so that helps you a little. Okay, let's stop for a second. Okay, now, in the rising trot, we have a movement that our hips come forward. And I can see sometimes you rise and the first thing that goes forward is your belt.
Okay.
Yeah? To get a little bit more the movement starting from here, I want to give you the feeling, if I'm allowed to touch. From the hips, we have muscles that go wrap around and they go to our sacrum. And this wrapping around that narrows the seat and helps you to lift here. And that when you rise, it's like you wrap around the hips and it's like you smile with your hips. You open the front. Huh? Have this feeling.
Don't
worry about the knees so much, because when the movement of the horse, that's a little different thing. Just that you have a feeling. Here's your outside of the bone that goes into the hip joint.
Yeah.
And that from there to the sacrum, you have a connection. And this wrapping around those muscles, around the hips, it's like a narrowing of the pelvis, but not a pinching of the big seat buttocks. It's an inside, it's a little higher up, okay. It's a little bit more inside, it's very hard to describe. And the best shortcut I found was saying smiling hips, that we open here and that we connect to there.
And not a big squeeze.
Not a big squeeze of the big ones, because then we can't, then everything's tight. Yeah. But it's this narrowing from inside and a little bit opening the front. Go again into rising trot and just think that you kind of have an elastic smile. Yeah, when you rise. It's like a good smile, if you keep it all the time, it's not honest, you know? So your hips have to have a little elastic, honest smile. And in the end of the lesson, I hope we have the triple smile. One here, one here, and one here. So I just think in the rising, yes. Okay. Okay, I can see something happening. Yeah, but even the third one's coming. Yeah. Yes. Anyway, that's a good way. Yes. Yeah. But feel it. The main thing that I see is it looks all of a sudden more stable. These smiling hips give you more stability in the rising, and you're not gone away. Very often in the rising trot, we leave the horse alone when we rise, and we're only there when we sit again. But this smiling hips gives you control by rising. Yes, feel this?
Yeah.
Let's change the rein. Yes. Good. Okay. And that helps you too, that your leg gets even more independent. Yeah, that the lower leg has nothing to do with the rising trot. You have a very nice leg position there now. Okay, your right leg very nicely relaxes down into the ankle. See if you can release your inside knee and ankle too. Yes, felt this?
Yeah.
And it's a little bit when you rise, you can allow your ankle to drop down. And when you sit down, you just kind of let the weight come with it. Yes, good, good. And think of the smiling a little again. You're losing the stability on the top. Yeah. And this, when you think of the smiling hip, your whole upper body stability comes from the center down, growing up like a flower. When you just say, I need more stability, we kind of often tense up in our shoulders. Yes, yes. Yeah, this is really a great picture for you, because I can see it really working its whole way up. Yes. Okay. Great, stay on the circle, ask for canter. And think the canter movement helps you to smile with the hip, because it pushes you to the smile. If you just feel that both hips, this wrapping around your sacrum, that you provide that, then the horse's movement makes the elastic smile. Feel this? Yes. Allow that to happen. Don't worry. Allow that to happen. Good. Yes. Good, good. Okay, and go forward to trot and rising trot. Just change the rhythm. Good. Okay, let's change the rein, and we'll give a canter on the other rein. And you can go from rising trot to canter, that you go sit, up, sit, up, sit, sit, canter. That's it. Felt that was much easier. Yeah? Okay. Good job. Okay, and go forward to rising trot again. Just change the rhythm of your pelvis. from tum tum to tap 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 tap. There you go. And let him walk. Now, how did that feel in the canter now?
Oh, very nice.
Yes?
Mm-hmm. But I was trying to think of just that, not that big squeezing, pushing,
yes.
Driving.
Yeah. Yeah. I could see you were very busy thinking and feeling. That's why I shut up a little bit, because otherwise it's too much. Yeah. And I really liked what you were doing there, because you were really experimenting with these smiling hips, how to connect with the horse. And I really like that. So the smiling hips, that's your homework in everything. Let's ask for the rising trot once more. And then we'll start playing with changing your rising trot. Not too much inside rein. We don't need to concentrate on that so much today. No. Okay. Yes, yes. But just make sure you have the reins in the same length, because it looks like you have the right rein shorter than the left. Okay. And now you take them around the whole arena. And you start going sit, sit, up, sit, sit, up. Never ending story, changing your rising trot. Sit, up, sit, sit, up. And think the one stride up, that's where you smile with your hips, that's where you wrap your hips to the sacrum. And then what I can see is that you're trying to shift your weight forward and back. Go normal rising trot again. Okay, now feel that when you have a good balance in the rising trot, your weight is not shifting forward back. You have the balance somewhere between your knees, and it's the pelvis is free to smile and go forward, down, forward, down, forward, down. Feel this? Now when you do the sit, sit, up, you stay forward. You just touch, touch, up. You're not shifting your weight. So yes, so that the horse is not disturbed. It carries you in the same place. Oops, when you get behind, then you feel this, yeah? Okay. You're confused, yeah? This sit, sit, up has nothing to do with real sitting trot. You kind of want to only touch the saddle, but not get heavy. That's better. That's better. And the horse is your best instructor, because when he reacts, then you've done too much. Oh. Okay, now we'll change it around and you'll do up, up, sit. Up, up, touch, up, up, touch. Yes, yes. Up, touch, up, up, touch, up, up, touch. Oops. Yes. That makes you fall behind. So you have to work a little bit with your upper leg and knees to stay thinking forward. Do it again. Up, 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 down, up, up, down. And the sitting down is never a backwards movement. Yeah? The horse is going forward, so when we sit down, it's still a forward movement. Yes, better. Good. 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 And now go rising trot again. And think in the normal rising trot, you're still, every time you sit down, you're thinking forward. Forward, forward, forward. Yes, good, good, good. Good, that's much better. Feel it? Yes. Yeah, it's like a wave that goes forward up and forward down. So every time you sit down, you're moving your pelvis forward down. and you wrap your hips to your sacrum. This connection exists and stays existing. That it makes such a difference into your whole upper body and shoulders. Very good. Change the rein. Okay, now start juggling with your hands. But you move your hands alternating up and down. Tuck, tuck. Yeah, keep contact. Shorten the reins a little. You have a ring on the that is attached on the rein. Moving your hands up and down does only help the contact, does not disturb it. Tuck, 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 tuck. Move, move. Both arms. I can only see the right. Juggle with both arms. Move, move. Move, 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 move. Left hand, get it to be free to. Yes, 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 yes. Get free in your left hand. Feel this? Yes. So we don't want to hold, we want to give. Yes. Okay. Now we'll do that like in music, half notes, half rhythm. One, 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 one. Okay. And in this one, one, you slowly get wider in your hands and then you get narrower again. Open up and open up and narrow again. Yes. That the rhythm becomes visible and feelable for you. Because all the aids you do have to stay inside the rhythm. You have to connect with the horse's rhythm. Tuck, 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 tuck. And if you get too slow, your horse slows down. Wow. Okay. Okay. And now we'll do a movement that you open both hands and close them. It's like playing the accordion. You open and you close. And open and close. And make sure that the closing is not a collapsing. Think it's an accordion and it's really heavy to close, that you have to squeeze it together. Yes, feel this? Open and squeeze. Open and squeeze. Oh, very good. And the opening is not so much your elbow, it comes like your chest opens too. Yes, it's like your hands have a movement that goes all the way to your sternum as that expands. Yes, good. And when you squeeze closed again, you want to keep the sternum open. Squeeze, yes, good. Beautiful. Okay. One more addition to it, we'll combine it with a breathing. When you breathe in, you open your hands. When you squeeze the air out, you squeeze your hands. Okay. And we can clearly see that you're breathing in longer than you were breathing out. Now try to breathe out longer. Take quickly the air in and take as long as possible to squeeze the air out. Oops. Better. Yes. Okay, let your horse walk and tell us what you felt in that.
Well, it's speaking of my weight training this morning. that slower coming in.
Yeah.
It was making me like pull all of this in, I thought.
Yes, yes.
And then I was trying to continue to think about the climbing hip.
Yeah, well, it's I'm telling you, I'm over freighting you. I mean, we're doing too much in one lesson.
That's okay. That video reminded me a little bit of time.
Yeah. Think we always have a balance of mobile and stable. If you're stable, he's mobile.
Okay.
If you're mobile, he will be more stable. The contact actually becomes more stable when your hands are moving.
Oh yes, I think I've heard that. Don't lock your arms.
Yeah, yeah. You've heard that before. Okay. Yeah. And the other thing was that with this opening and closing, we connected your inside and outside hand.
Okay.
Because you're riding with one rein, not with two reins. And this one rein connects through the horse's mouth. Okay. If you ride too much and there's an inside and an outside rein, then you could just as well buy some clips and clip them into the side of the horse's mouth. There's a reason we use a bit that goes through the horse's mouth to the other hand. Yeah? And this opening and closing made the contact steady between inside and outside. And then the horse started looking for the contact much easier. They start reaching for it. Yeah? So that's the second thought behind it. Okay. And I needed this a little bit to give you more stability if we now want to work a little bit on the sitting trot. Yes. Okay. I know. What we'll do is we'll take the stirrups away. We'll be. Mm-hmm. Now, let's have a look.
You know, in November.
November is a no stirrup month.
I think December in our group.
I didn't know that.
Okay. Too.
Fine. Okay. So, what will. Just it doesn't pinch, that it's flat. Okay. I don't want you to have blue marks tomorrow. I mean.
that'll give me quite a memory.
That'll give you quite a memory. Okay. What we'll do now is you ride walk, you do that, what we did at the end of her lesson, that you breathe out and use the last bit of breathing out to ask him for trot. Only 3-4 steps and walk again.
Okay.
Not more. Okay?
Okay, my little buddy.
So, take up his reins. And breathe out, take all the air out, and at the end of the breathing out, that's where you ask. And walk again. Not bad at all. And you could feel how that breathing out gave you more stability in the inside. So, really think it's only 2-3 steps, nothing more. You just want to kind of start the trot and stop the trot. And walk again. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, that's already more. Yeah. Okay. Once more. And walk again. Good. Now, for these few steps, don't let him, because he gets faster, you get left behind. This stays over your pelvis. So you breathe out, you stay, the basket stay aligned, and walk again. Because I know it's very tempting when we lean back, we have this fake more security, but that doesn't help the horse. Yeah? So that's why I want only a few steps, but with a good alignment. And again. Good. Very good. Much softer. Now tell me the moment when the first trot step comes and when you walk, when the first walk step comes. That you say now. Mm-hmm. And walk again. Good. And again into trot. You tell me when the first... Oh, you were too late. Yes. And again. Yes. Very good. Oops, you were late. Yeah. That teaches you to feel how much do you have to prepare and when is the actual transition happening. Yeah? Because in your aids, you must make a difference between preparation and execution. And your leg and your reins, they belong to the preparation. It's this breathing out inside in your body that makes the final now. But to know the timing, to feel the timing, we need to feel when the horse is ready to start lifting his 500 kilos off the ground. So you must feel that the horse is getting more and more energy, and you must make a clear decision together with the horse when both of you are starting. Yes. Ah. And then it was not so difficult to sit.
No.
Because you were prepared. You knew what was coming. And you were in control of that. Once you're out of the balance, it's hard to get back in. Yeah? But if we're the one that's organizing it, we're staying organized. So do it again. And that teaches you more than 50 rounds of not sitting well, you know?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Once we're left behind, I mean, the vicious circle is starting, and to get out of a vicious circle is the hardest thing to do. The best thing is to avoid getting into it, you know? Okay. Let's change the rein. Same thing on the other rein. Now she's sitting really nice. Yeah. When I saw you warming up, I was quite surprised how difficult the sitting trot was for you. Because the rest looked all so nice. I said, no, come on, there's just a block here. It's not an inability. You will be able to sit really nice very soon. Yes. Hip is free. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Okay. And especially on this rein, don't let him look so much to the inside. Think his two shoulders are two walls, and he has to have his head and neck in between that. If he all the time looks that far inside, he scratches his nose on the wall. And he can't be in balance because his energy line can't go through. You create into the trot a certain energy that goes from behind through your body to his shoulders. And energy needs to be maintained. Yeah? So feel the energy goes through from behind to the front, and from the front it bounces back to the hind, and from the hind to the front. And your balance is kind of organizing that this energy ball can go through. But if you overflex, if you collapse, then the energy has a way out. It gets lost. Yeah? And anyway, we need to shop fresh energy again and again, but if we lose it, then we have to work even harder. Maintain it as much as possible. Good. Okay. Okay, I'll give you one more picture that in the sitting trot, you want to feel how the horse's back moves, not just up and down, but that there's a little bit of a lateral movement too. Thank you. right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Can you feel this? And it's not shifting your weight. It's just allowing the horse to rotate in the back. Yes. Yes. And you want to feel this rotation changing when the horse's back is in the highest moment, when the horse's back is up. If you flex him too much, you can't feel that because he can't lift the back. Yes. Let the energy come through. Let him be straight. Yes. Ulf's favorite word is align him. Yes, and you want to feel that highest point and rotate right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Let him rotate his back. That is extremely important for him because that's for him a little difficult. Yes, now it's coming. Feel this? You have to, with your seat, invite him to bring his back up. And there he needs to rotate, otherwise he can't get the energy through. Otherwise he hollows his back and you're sitting somewhere and nothing is happening. More outside rein, give your inside hand forward. Yes, there, there, yes. Okay, let him walk. Now that was quite a long sitting trot.
It was quite a long sitting trot.
From but only doing a few steps. Take your stirrups back. Yes. You're doing. Because when we have stirrups, our reflex is to push into them, and then we're not connecting deep anymore.
Okay.
And
we're just putting our weight down here.
We're doing this instead of using that. Yeah. And it's really now with the stirrups, you will feel it will not be as good, probably, I don't mind. But just think, all the stirrup does, it carries the weight of your knee. But it does, you're not yet in the position that you have to use the push down in the stirrup as an aid. You know, that comes much later. At the moment, and this pushing the heel down too much locks your foot and it locks your hip. You just rest it. You can even pull the heel a little up or a little down, that it's soft there. That if you have the feeling your ankle is butterscotch, whatever, I don't know. Yeah? Jellyfish down there, yeah? Okay, and just do these few steps of trot again. And you don't need the legs because the stirrups are virtually not existing. Yes, 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 good. Very good. Very good. Oh. Okay. Okay, and then you're allowed to go rising trot. And let him stretch a little. Okay, and think of those smiling hips, that you have this connection from your hip joint to the sacrum, that you have your horizon line, that your back stretches in between, because if you want your horse to stretch, you need to stretch. Yes, yes, he is waiting for you now. Yes. And soften your left elbow and change the rein. Okay, and let him go into walk. Well done, you. Oh, how did that feel now?
Good.
Yeah, that's always the thing.
Yeah, good. I think the smiling hips is going to be a good mental thing for me.
Yeah. Good. Yeah, no, I could see so much changing now from what you showed in the warm-up to now, and it was like once you understood or felt something, you could go with it. And it's a really good match, the horse and you. You better. Yeah.
Yeah.
Great. Great.
I gotta not fall off when we jump, though. But I think this will help that too.
It will. It will, because that gives that stability.
Because that's when I get myself in trouble, if getting back and getting bounced out.
How do you make your hips smile?
How do you make the hips smile? You use those muscles that are attached here on the side, and they go to the inside of the sacrum. And I just give this feeling of wrapping that around without pinching the lower muscles, that it's a little higher, so you kind of narrow the pelvis. And that I gave her the picture that this widens.
Okay.
So that she has this opening here.
It's just
yeah. How do you